Beauty, Reedy's got it.
Good on you, Reed.
The daddy baby.
Now, it seems that the mother was totally devoted to the child. For 5 years, she sat trying to help in every way she knew possible until finally she couldn't bear the suffering any longer. The painkillers weren't working. The prognosis was hopeless. Now, I just wonder what any of you would have done in the same situation.
I can't wait any longer. I'm going to kill her.
She's had too much punch. She's going nuts.
No, you listen
I
to me.
I just want to kill her.
Look, we all do, but we can't do nothing about her tonight.
She shouldn't have killed her.
Tell me, what do you do?
Oh, well, I came into a little money when my father died. Don't have to work.
Lady of leisure, eh? That sounds pretty good.
Oh, I managed to keep busy.
What are you doing?
What any sensible person would do.
What an idiot!
Stand back, Chucky.
Oh.
Oh, God, are you all right?
Give us a minute to think. Oh, geez, your back, a wallet.
Lucky for you, you're a friend of Jules, or I would have clobbered your heart.
What do you mean?
We had a bit of a disagreement.
Bastard tipped the goodies down the sink. Why the hell did you do that? I thought you were on our side.
Not when it comes to drugs. I came in here looking for booze. I was worried about your parole.
But why tip the coke out? Sure, a bit of booze down the drain, but coke's worth a fortune.
Because it's dangerous.
Oh, well, you know. You're the doctor.
Too damn right I know. I've seen too many people come to grief on that stuff. I don't want to see Julie or any of the women join them.
I wouldn't have taken any, Steve.
Oh, getting drunk wasn't too bad either. You're supposed to have a brain.
Oh, listen to it.
I don't think you understand what it's like to be in here at all.
Jeez, a bloody domestic and you're not even hitched yet. What happened to you? You sprung a leak or something?
Look, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to sound...
Oh, no.
What's wrong?
It's okay. I'll think of something. I'll explain.
Oh, no, you don't. Get down there. Make like you're fixing a pipe. Give him a wrench or something. A span or anything. Just do it.
Get there and look like you're fixing a pipe and make it go.
G'day,
Mrs. M.
What's going on here?
It's a blocked pipe, Mrs. Morris. Steve was passing. We thought we'd get him to fix it.
Yeah, it's nothing serious. Just something someone flushed down they shouldn't have. Right, Steve?
Yeah, it's okay now, though.
Oh, good. Lucky you were here. Come along, Connors. It's lock up. Time you're back in your cell.
It's a good job you did there, Steve. I really owe you.
Patterson, get something and clean this mess up, will you?
Just call me Floss.
Always bloody me.
See you tomorrow.
Okay. What's the story? Reed seemed madder in hell.
Oh, nothing much. The cocaine, he
what?
Well, he's got these really strong ideas about drugs, and he washed it down the sink.
You kidding?
No.
Stinking bastard!
He didn't try that one again, not round us anyway.
Oh, I'm not surprised.
Now, don't forget, next time you feel like a game, come down and play the course. Best round here in my book.
Yes, I certainly will.
Good.
Now I must be going.
Ah.
Thank you for the pleasant company.
Likewise, Miss Ferguson. I can't remember when I enjoyed myself more. And hopefully I'll see you next time you drop in. I'm a regular customer here, I'm afraid.
Yes. Good night, Mr. Hinton.
Oh, yes, good night, and take good care of that strong light arm, eh?
Oh, yes. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
I mean, who's he bloody think he is? God or something? It's all right for him. He can go home and have a good time whenever he bloody likes.
He had his reasons, Lex.
Bloody nerve, if you ask me. I'd have donged him too if I'd been there. Bugger it.
Oh, what? Jeez, I nearly stuck my toothbrush up my nose.
Settle down, Connors.
Yeah, well, I don't know why you're mad at me.
Oh, I'm not mad at you, Chook.
Well, you shouldn't be mad at Steve either. I mean, it's not like he's being a screw. He was worried about us.
Protecting his bit of fluff, you mean?
Thanks very much.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just him and Nance. They seem to think anything that's fun is bad for you.
Well, Nancy was right, too. You should be thinking about that baby now.
Yeah, I suppose so. Hey, Jules.
What?
How'd you like to be a godmum?
Me?
Yeah.
I've never been one before.
Oh, you'd be right. I mean, if you got stuck, you could just teach it that junk that's in your head. Sammy buying a set of encyclopedias.
I'd love to.
Hitting out at people like that doesn't achieve anything, and it's already got you 3 years in here.
Yeah, 2 years, 329 days, but who's counting?
You might have killed him.
So it made me feel better. The bastard just blew me bankroll. I still got to figure out how to tell Bongo and the Sheilas who ordered the stuff.
Good health is more important than money.
Yeah, yeah, and coke puts warts on your nose. I've heard it all before. So how about you hang up your tambourine and let me get some shut-eye?
Doesn't it concern you that the girls might get hooked on the stuff? You've got a responsibility
Look,
there.
The warriors are old enough to make up their own bloody minds. So how about switching off the motor and shutting down for a few hours? It's boring enough around here as it is.
You all right?
Yeah, fine.
Good. Now, don't worry. I've spoken to the women about why you're in here. A couple of them might be a little antagonistic, but Connors is prepared to listen.
Connors? Isn't she the one you told us about? The one who beat up that officer or something?
She's no angel cat, but she is fair. So long as she feels you're sorry.
How can I be sorry? You saw how much Linda was suffering.
Well, the women didn't. And it's them you've got to convince. They must hear it from you that you did it out of compassion.
I don't see why I should have to prove that to anybody.
If you don't, they might mistake your holding back as callousness.
Well, what if they do? I'm here to be punished, aren't I?
All right, Kath. I've got to go now, but I'll try and pop in later.
Bob? Talk to Alan, will you? Tell him I'm all right.
Bloody time. My stomach thinks my throat's been cut.
Just put the tray down and move out.
Hope you like caustic soda.
She's done.
What's going on?
Nothing. I just put the tray down like you said.
Pick it up. I'm hungry, Kelly.
On a bloody diet.
Suit yourself. Hurry it up, Patterson.
Oh, don't worry. I'm not staying here any longer and I have to.
I'll get someone in to clean that up.
You can't get it past your hangover. Give it to Lurch.
Do you want it?
No, I can't eat me own.
Look, if you don't feel well, I'll get one of the officers to take you to Sister Hall.
I won't do any good. Just didn't sleep, that's all. Kept having bad dreams.
Hey, Lexi asked me to be the baby's godmum last night.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? I'm godmum to most of my sister's kids.
Great, you can tell me what to do. I don't want to muck it up.
Oh, no worries, Chook.
So she's starting to care about what happens to the baby?
Well, I think she paid attention to what you said, Nance. I mean, she'd never admit it to anyone.
Mm. Oh, good.
Yeah, no one minds taking advice from you, Nance, as long as you don't overstep the mark like Steve Bloody Ryan. No offence, sweetheart, but that was a dirty trick he pulled on us last night.
Look, he was just worried about Julie's parole.
Arrest, Nance?